this is Wintry Kite with the 8th chapter of Child of Light, the Highest of the High. As you might notice, there is a little bit missing. That is because of two reasons. The first one was that when I originally recorded the 8th chapter, I didn't actually record it. Then I played a second save file to 8, and then when I got up to here, my tower crashed, and I am so going to play the whole damn game again. Not once. So you will have to live that you missed a little bit. Sorry. Basically, what happened is that the old, an old guard for a mother came by and was like, "Hey, promise me you'll fight against the night and I'm going to free you." And he said, "Okay, so we promised." And he let us out. That's, Angus, by the way. I don't actually know how that's pronounced. It's an Irish name, I think. And yeah, last in the last episode we found out that our stepmother is actually Umbra, Queen of Night, what is that? And that our oldest sister, actually Umbra and her two daughters, who are our stepsisters, have killed our mother, the Queen of Light. Who would have thought number two? But the Umbra couldn't do a spell work on us because of the crown, and they couldn't just remove the crown from us for some reason, so they left us in the cell to rot. Considering this rain and how flimsy our dress is, I'd say Aurora would have died of a nasty flu within a couple days. No torture required. But Angus definitely let us out and let us down here to where our friends were imprisoned. And now we got them back, and now the theory is we want to get out. But first, there's a little bit of stuff around that we can only collect with Ubisoft. Which I'm going to do now. Interface spoiler, or rather gameplay spoiler, with a few of those glowing chests that can only be opened with Ubisoft, but we didn't have them, so we are going to we are going back to the temple of the moon at some point once we get the moon. But first we have to get out of here. And I completely forgot which in the meantime I completely forgot which voices I used for everyone, so bear with me. Nice to march beside ya. I hope I'm not crying, but why are tears drawn on your face? To impart the humor of life. Oh, I didn't get it. Exactly right. So, while our sister, stepsister, Nora slash Nox, respects us from her own words. She's still listening to her mother regarding everything. And it was pretty sudden that she's not actually going to stay in our party that long. So she has the same unaccessible skills that everyone else had. Down we go, not a moment to lose. Crepusculum is on her way, the prisoners to abuse. What are the risks? Will we get caught? Run, we have to get out of here, trot! Oh yeah, there's items here though. There's point. Always. An open market strife. Love of a fair bowl must name Margaret, who I plan to impress and hope will be my wife. Such tragedy looms on the horizon nearly in sight. You still dare to love, exquisite. You realize we're all doomed, right? Trista, stop being a one thing your save file also comes with is two confessions I forgot to collect. One of them I'm pretty sure I can still collect if I go there, but the other I don't know if I can return. So I click away and we'll be reading it shortly. Isn't this well, Tristis? We're in the same troop. In battle, I suppose our act will be sharpened. You always make me laugh. My only fan, thanks to you, I'm not disheartened. Tristis is the life of the party. Flying into them because I am not actually able to fly in any sensible manners. I didn't go to flying school. I still drop things. I swear it's intentional. I wish I had stayed in Batcourt.
In your travels, have you seen my missing piece?
It's likely fruitless. Your search you should cease. Stop being a downer, Tristis! The important thing is trying. Considering my tower keeps crashing, I am going to pause recording here and do some allocations. I'll be right back. Crepusculum holds the moon near the bridge's top. You join us now? Princess, my name is Angus, the Katigida, my clan. Soldiers, we are the best. We strike with Jupiter's lightning when we are put to the test. Once darkness fell, sword and spear we raised to the sky. The night she arrived in a chariot, flaming serpents at her side. By Erin she flung magic and none of us could fly. My clan to the top of the tower drew, the highest of the high. Metal gleamed faint in the twilight, we were destined to die. The knight took the tower, condemned our sentence she was to carry out, until my sword I raised and pledged to aid her. She sent the other Katigida to jail with a shout. Princess, I must free them, there is no doubt. Enter the prison with me or fly. You must decide. I'm gonna do that quest. We shall help the Katigida out. Your Majesty, beware the other guards, dark creatures devout. Angus is trying to part. I don't know if I said it in this recording, but he sounds the name. I have no idea how to pronounce the name, but he sounds Irish. S plus space to jump down, I would have needed that earlier. So now we are gonna do freedom. Christmas. Ow. Everything there? There's a settlement here, but deserted. Rise, my warriors! Where could they be? No, all trapped in Aaron's labyrinth cell. Oh woe, the brave Katagida, fall to night's spell. We must free them. The gate lies at the camp's center. The labyrinth is magical. Be careful when you enter. Probably there. I'm going to check these tents first, though. What a curious dwelling. My old station, home of the captain of the Lemurian Guard. Here I raised my younger brother, taught him how to charge. Wait until you hear our stories, princess. So many battles he and I fought together. If the queen heard him! Come, we must rescue them down in the nether. Here though. Magic cell, it doesn't matter if you have your weapons because you can't use them. Oh hey. I think the hair animation is missing. For your sacred light. Stop it, you're making me turn bright. No, it's blushing. Yes, just put it. It's kind of rude that we are plundering the possessions of prisoners. Oh, our hair is back. Minor graphic bugs. There's coming. That is not a bark though. That's not even a tree. Thank the loose leaves, your reward. I feel safe behind your sword. Much gratitude for bravely fighting as the prince's ward. Aurora, just one question. How come princess he gets to call you? Because Finn, it's simply an expression. Ready to brave the labyrinth. This prison seems ancient. Who made it? Some say Aaron, the explorer, who hailed from distant shores. Lemuria founded by the Four. Ugh. Hey, which door before we are buried alive? The statue, Aaron, she will serve us as a guide. This is one thing I haven't noticed. It took me a while to notice in the first trial of the labyrinth. The statue here has a symbol on her shield. The moon? And each of these doors has a symbol. This here is a sun symbol. This here has got a star symbol. So, those doors are going to lead to, dead ends, basically. They're just repeat. We need to, and neither of those have a statue, so we need to follow the moon door. Atlas has a passive ability he can skill, which I am about to skill. It's just that I... Oh god damn it! That I haven't gotten a chance to skill yet because I wanted the regular area effect first. Don't cost extra mana. Where he gets a 10% chance to just kill a monster on striking it, and it's ridiculous. Excellent sword, sir. Why, thank you. You show promise. Where did you mine that metal? From the silver tears of comets. Ever though, where do I get new merchandise? And here we got moon door. Let's go through. Star door, which is what we are gonna check for other merchandise. Yeah, the relevant hallways also have more chests. Now, where are we? Moving through this labyrinth cleverly. Whoops, wrong one. And nearby. Next door will be the sun door. This is visible on this very ancient Greek statue of Aaron. I'm possibly stuck now because I can't remember if I placed the question in the former in the crashed video or. This one already, but I'm asking myself why was Umbra banished? Of course, oh, Yardar, she is evil, but what was the start of darkness? Why did she? Was it because she was banished? Was her prophecy? And she's also once told Katagida stories, but I never thought I'd see one.
We served in the Queen's Guard. Since the rift was opened, the rain begun. You are Aristati, I presume. You live in a balloon. Your clan or floating fortress designed. You, warrior, are always welcome.
Called a warrior by a Katagida. That would go out of his head.
Or mind. As it's plainly possible, I neither have a voice for... or friendly Firefly either. Another spoiler is basically that if you activate the flowers, they just point at the right door, which I think is kind of lame. Like, way to make it even more obvious than it already is. Oh yeah, by the way, we got Lightning Strike 3 already. As you can see, it's a little bit more intelligently scattered. And I'm not actually sure I'm going to go back to the old save file. Unless I forget about recording, in which case I need to. Yeah, one thing is that I should have been suspicious is that Tristis here has the very similar makeup as Nora in terms of spells, because he has Unstoppable, he has Haste. So he would basically replace Nora at least for a time. Kind of do watch her back. Oh Lord! Strike terror far and wide. I'm afraid to fight by your side. Do you remove your mask when you sleep? I never sleep. My eyes open, I will keep. I can't access the map. Yeah, because then I would have been able to teleport. The chase from the line of the crossroads associated with the sea. That they are royalty, but somehow don't don't consider Aurora a sister because of said royalty. Which is a little bit odd because my name should be royalty too. Usurper or not, her mother might have been. Your strength inspires me.
Such a compliment is an honor. From one salad like you.
No, I am missing a piece inside. Instead, I won.
Inside we are incomplete. It is our nature. Keep searching, you will come together.
How can that peace be? No peace, never. Then the search will go on forever.
Well, yes, you never stop learning. Crown says false on it. Are you the one? Yes, you are the one. Aha! Who has opened Aaron's path of freedom? Behold, a princess of light. Thank you on behalf of the Katagida princess. Aurora. Aurora, now we can again protect the starry skies and floating peaks of Lemuria. Brother. What is the traitor doing here? He led the princess to you, idiot. You should have let us die with honor. I will have words with you, brother. The queen of night you served, for shame. Cuchulain, please, be calmer. That's why I said Irish. Brothers, we no more be. You are banished, fallen from grace, flee. Hey! He's part of my honor guard, asshole! For that I'm gonna steal all your stuff. We are free from the Queen's prison. A fortress we will reclaim, the Katagida have risen. Your Majesty, we will assume our posts on high. Our duty we will die for, to protect the Lemurian sky. Yeah, but you are a lot more used to me alive. Night shifted Aaron's labyrinth, trapping us inside. Thank you for finding the path, turning the tide. Bye. My path I must set. The Katagida thank you for our freedom. We will not forget. Yeah, you can also remember that the person who freed me and brought me here was the Dwarfia. I am an outcast worse than this. The grace to your name, Princess Aurora. You bravely shielded your clan. Remember who you are, the great warrior of your. That's what happens if I have to speak that too quickly. I am not a good voice actor. Still in training. That melody, strong like armor. Join us to regain your honor. Now let us leave this tower. The moon we shall return this hour. Thinking we are on our way to a boss fight. Yes, we are on our way to the boss fight. But first we are going to collect a few herbs. And Cordelia, sweet sister, hand the moon to me. Aurora, you look wretched. Not fit for nobility. A ruler you will never be. When you parade around so commonly. You were always sweet to me. I never liked the way you smiled. Or the way you chewed your food. The way you ran through the halls with your cheerful mood. You were a perfect disgrace. And I, Crepusculum, aim to put you in your place. That's not even Arthur murder, that's just jaywalking. What did she do to you?
Thank you.
was. Well, what do we have to for a time? fuck ton of experience we all just got. The moon yours for now shall be, but mother will end. Puberty, it seems. And a new dress. Well, where did Aurora go? Nicholas, have you become smaller? Maybe it's the light of the moon. But I think you've gotten taller. Who cares what size Aurora is? We just killed a dragon. What a team! Our strength drowns the competition. To the extreme! What do we do now? We must recover the sun. To the lowest of the low. Quickly, let us run! Yeah. That was the 8th chapter, but before we're going to end it... Mr. Elmer's eyes only. I heard strange sounds in the forest again last night. I am worried that someone from the club followed me. I found the hut exactly where it was marked in the book, but you aren't here. Where are you? Sophie, Ashton, Ellis. I wonder if we are going to meet Mr. Elmer and Mrs. Ellis at some point. For Mr. Elmer's eyes only. I've spied a group of men with funny beards picking plants in the forest. They look a little like the gnomes my aunt purchased on the branches of a Christmas tree. From the book, I suppose these are Kepoli? I noticed something I missed in the pages this time. A race that lives in the mountains and bathes in the hot springs called Amara. You've circled it. That's where I'm going next. More notes from the Balthazar. A powerful secret was hidden somewhere, although there seem to be a lot of secrets, at least to me anyway. The Hollow Pact, a betrayal that led to some kind of war between family lines, caused by or about the Rift. Afterward, someone from Sinbel's line was expelled into our world by a Queen of Light and cursed to live in darkness if she returned. The Rift? Something in the 1300s must be important. Sophie Ashton Ellis. So, there's some background here about... Yeah, there's the Hollow Pact, the betrayal between family lines, the Queen of Night and the Queen of Light. So they're cousins of some sort, although the Queen of Night is from Sinbel's line. And the Queen of Light apparently is not. And the mother of Umbra was banished to the world of the Duke, to the world of Miss Alice, to the world of Mr. Elma, to the world Aurora grew up in, and for some reason the Queen of Light followed. I wonder if she was aiming at some sort of reconciliation and was instead met with a fuck no, not for what you did. I suppose we will find out. But for now, this is the end of chapter 8. I'm sorry there's something missing in the beginning. It was mostly just me running around, Aurora running around with Angus and bashing on some monsters and then collecting the rest of the party. And I'll see you guys next time. Bye bye!